And welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. Boy, we have a tough question today talking about Jonathan. Jonathan has a program start date and a program end date. And the way that this works is that can span up to 60 days, which means that it could include 1, 2, or 3 months. And he has a certain program cost, and he needs to prorate that cost into each of the monthly buckets. So, you know, in this case, we have part of April, part of May, and he needs to allocate that cost. We need to figure out that there's 16 days in April, 14 days in May, so that way April gets 16 30ths and May gets 14 30ths. This is a really tough question, but there's an amazing feature. And I'm going to start to talk about this feature today, and then we'll bring it home tomorrow. I'm going to come down here to a lower section of the spreadsheet where I'm just going to have basically 5 days, the 15th, 16th, 17th, 18th, and 19th, 5 days. And I'm going to use the indirect. I'm going to ask for the indirect, and I'm going to build a reference that's A35. So in other words, that date in A35, a colon, and then the date in B35. Now, of course, Excel shows us 415, but what's it really storing there? If I press Control and then the grave accent, you'll see that what it's storing is 39,553 through 39,557. So if I come over and look at this formula and use the evaluate formula icon, what we're going to get is we're building a reference to the rows, the five rows, 39,553 through 39,557. This is an amazing way to take two cells and coerce it into a large array, in this case that contains five cells, but in reality might contain up to 60 cells in Jonathan's case. So let me close this and show you what we would do with that. In the next formula, I use that same indirect, but for every item in the indirect, I ask for the row number. Now, basically, that's going to convert from five cells to five numbers, and it's going to be the five numbers from 39,553 through 39,559. We'll evaluate. And you see that I end up with an array here with the five dates represented as numbers. Now, with that, I can start to do some cool things, and we'll take a look at how we can use that information in tomorrow's Netcast. Well, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.